Welcome. I am with Sambandh Health Foundation. Sambandh works in the area of mental health and with people with mental illness. And today is a very important day for us, and for that matter, for everybody in the mental health field. Today, the 30th of March, is World Bipolar Day. Bipolar, as some of you know, is a mood disorder. Characterized by elevation and depressiveness or depression in moods. It's a very, very common amongst the severe mental disorders, and it is important that we take this more seriously. I'm delighted that we have with us today Mr. Vijay Nallawala, a pioneer and an experiential expert in this field, to talk to us. Welcome, Vijay.
Thank you, Rajiv ji. It's an honor for me to be invited to talk on this chat on World Bipolar Day by Sambandh Health. I came to know about the kind of work that you people are doing. It is something that inspires us and shows us the roadmap for what we could do with our own proposed organization. Bipolar disorder is a serious mental illness which entails extreme swings of mood. When we say mood swings, every human being experiences swings of mood from a low phase to a slightly higher emotional phase. But we are not talking about those kind of mood swings in bipolar disorder. The depressive phases can be crushing, and the elevated mood phase, which is known as either hypomania or mania, can make a person do things which are on the verge of recklessness, bravado. There is an exaggerated sense of a person's capabilities, and so the consequences are very nasty because of this mood phase. It is not always that the person is swinging in between a depressive mood phase or an elevated mood phase. There are, thankfully, so-called normal mood phases in between also. Yeah. This illness can be managed with the help of medication, therapy, and of course, a life of self-discipline. It is said that bipolar disorder does not have a cure, but it can be managed, and we see that many people are living with it very successfully, juggling their careers, family life, and so on. I myself have been living with bipolar disorder for over 43 years now. Symptoms first came up when I was at age 14 in my 10th standard, critical 10th standard, when I was doing my schooling. It was a phase of 6 months or 8 months of depression, and I did not know what was happening to me. It hit me again at age 17 when I was in my first year at college. This time the episode was much more intense and severe. I experienced psychosis along with it. But my sense of the suffering was that I was going mad. I did not understand that what I was, what was happening to me was depression, and that I could seek help for it. These kind of episodes repeated a couple of years later, but all of them went undiagnosed and therefore untreated. Lack of awareness back then also was one of the reasons for me not getting treated in time. A full 26 years after the first onset of symptoms, my diagnosis happened, and it happened in dramatic circumstances, because my full-blown manic episode, my symptoms were over the top, and it was very obvious to my family members that I needed urgent medical help. A psychiatrist at that time diagnosed me with manic depressive illness, as bipolar disorder was known back then. My 1 week stay at a hospital in Andheri, Mumbai was possibly the worst week of my life. Coming to terms with the new reality was crushing. The first thought that came to my mind was, I am now mentally ill. For a successful entrepreneur, the thoughts that began hitting me were, what would my colleagues say? What would my peers say about me now? How would I be gauged by my competitors and my clients and so on? It was a crushing thought. The total lack of awareness about mental health at that way back then in 2003 meant that I felt all alone. It felt that it was only I who had this kind of an illness, and it was very unique, and that there was nobody around me who could have had this kind of a condition, and it was the rarest of rare of a diagnosis, which is not true as we know. Going forward, I realized that there are millions of bipolar disorder affected persons living just in India. My own recovery journey was a long drawn out one. It wasn't that after my hospitalization, after treatment started, that things came back to hunky-dory overnight. It took many, many years for things to stabilize. Although I did not keep my diagnosis a secret as such, I had no platform to share my story on until that time. The explosion of social media brought in just such an opportunity for me. And I had started a blog way back in 2012, which became a platform for me to share my journey of a person living with bipolar disorder and how I was coping with it. A story on it about my recovery from bipolar disorder drew a lot of comments and feedback. And that gave the idea to one of my mentor friends that this could lead to something much more meaningful. He came up with the idea of setting up a portal where people from our community could exchange thoughts, where stories could be shared, information could be shared, and we could come together as one. The whole concept of Bipolar India was created by was the brainchild of Puneet Bhatnagar. He launched the web portal and set it up for me to work on. This was way back in March 2013. What began as a web portal gradually took form as an offline peer support meet movement. It has been now, we are into a fifth year of monthly peer support meets in Mumbai. And these meets are spreading in other cities of Mumbai, of India as well, such as Delhi and Bangalore. We have also been conducting the World Bipolar Day conference for 5 years in a row in Mumbai, where delegates and members and participants drawn from all over the country gather, you know, on the 30th of March each year. Our strength has been our peer support community. To give it further shape, we are setting up Bipolar India in the form of as a foundation, in the form of a charitable trust, so that we can increase the outreach of our community, outreach of our organization, and increase the scope of the work which we are doing. Firstly, sometimes it is good to begin with a level of high awareness to understand what the condition is, to understand the nitty-gritties of what bipolar disorder are, what are the sort of medications that we need to take, how does therapy help us, what are the holistic approaches that a person has to sort of adopt to be stable. That is just one area of managing of something as serious and as chronic as bipolar disorder. Life is much beyond an illness. A human being is an entity which we should look at in a far bigger, on a far bigger canvas than just managing an illness, isn't it? Our endeavor is to make sure that each and every of our community members can live a life of fulfillment. Yeah, that is possible because within our own community, we have brilliant talent. People with PhDs, people with multiple engineering degrees and a combination of masters in business administration and so on and so forth. Some are doing brilliantly in their corporate jobs. So the talent is there, functionality is there. Sometimes people, there are people who are struggling, they need to be handled and sort of we need to make sure that they can be nurtured and assimilated into society as fully functional human beings rather than people living with mental illness. The label of mental illness is itself so limiting that a person starts looking at a person with mental illness with a different lens altogether. The same person, if you wouldn't know that he or she has any mental illness, you would gauge that person's capabilities differently. These perspectives need to change. Yeah? A person living with bipolar disorder can live a life as functionally, as successfully, and as happily as any other person who doesn't have that condition. That is the message that I would like to share with anybody watching this video, because there are so many examples of people who have lived with this condition, overcome it, and are inspiring other people to sort of deal with their issues. Illness should not be looked at only the mental health aspect of it. Don't we also need to consider overall wellness? I call myself a mental wellness warrior because of certain reasons. Along with bipolar disorder, for close to 35 years, I have been struggling with acute asthma. Asthma which was life-threatening and almost took my life on a couple of occasions. So for me, fitness and wellness means a 360 degree form of wellness. A wellness which encompasses my peace of mind, my physical health, and my ability to do whatever I wish to do. So I've lived with bipolar disorder for 43 years. And let me tell you, it's been a journey of ups and downs. It's not one smooth journey, okay? At the beginning, when I was first diagnosed, and even before diagnosis, it crushed me, right? We need to evolve from that, right? What comes to us as intense suffering, the moment we start looking at it as a challenge, our perspective changes and we look for solutions to recover from it, to deal with the issue that is on hand, right? Beyond recovery, I evolved to a state of increased perceptions, resilience, and empathy towards my community and outreach to my community. I do not know without bipolar disorder whether this would have happened, whether I would have been in a position to be of help to society. So it is very important to get the perspective right. Above all, today I would like to share one thing with you. I live with a so-called serious mental illness, and despite all of this, I have fulfillment in my relationships. I have a family, I have a daughter, and we bond together as well as anybody else you would see in your life. Yeah, so there's hope on that front as well. Yeah. The people with bipolar disorder do not have to live a life of isolation. They can be part of mainstream life as far as family is concerned, society is concerned, and workplace is concerned. Thank you.